Hi guys, welcome to Rootstem, and in today's video we're going to be painting lots of orks. Hi guys, thanks for joining me. Right, before we begin, please like, share, subscribe, hit that notification button if you do want to see more. Trying to get through quite a lot of models at the moment, so a lot of my painting tutorials might be how to do X, Y, and Z of this. I've also got some future painting tutorials on Sisters of Battle coming up, and some more on the Illustrious Imperial Guard and how to paint quite a lot of them as quick as you possibly can. Now, these orcs here are a commission. I have 29. We've also got Kaptin Badruk in this particular set. We've got a unit of Kommandos, we've got a unit of Flash Gitz, and I believe these are the Lootaz, I think so, which is wanting all painting in Blood Axe styles. Prep wise, these were second hand when he gave them to me, so I'd already sprayed them black. I'm going to have to spray them black again because it's not really bright. These of course have been glued and washed because terrible material to work with. Absolutely detest it. I'd wish we'd just keep them in metal and these in plastic. Flash Gitz are a nice unit. They're a quite big unit. They're big orcs because of course for classes a knob in the game, so you've got two wounds apiece, but they've also got really, really awkward, massive weapons. Now, what I've done is kept the weapons off the actual models to make it easier to get to the models, because we're going to be doing some spray painting. And once we've managed to get all the models sprayed up, we're going to be doing a little bit of airbrushing to get some of the base colours on. And once we've got the base colours on, we're just going to be basically creating some camouflage. If it was me and I'm painting all these models, I'd have painted them goth. Actually, I do prefer, because I'm an old school Armageddon guy. I like my Steel Legion, I like my Blood Angels, you know, and I like the idea of Goth Orcs led by Gazgul, you know, tearing down some hives and having Commissar Yarrick go right against him. Flash kit wise, this guy's probably going to be a little bit darker with some dark purples. I have seen somebody that's done a map, so I'm going to try and create some form of map on his little tabard or loincloth, but one of them things. So so basically all I'm going to do with these guys is spray all of them black. So it's going to be an all black spray to start with, and then we're going to come in. I might do a little bit of Xenophil highlighting, not too much, and then we're going to be coming in with some normal colors. So we've got our models all sprayed black, including these guys, making sure about all the aspects of them, get in there with a brush, work it in. And we're going to be using some grey sear to do the Xenophil highlighting. I've got my trusty tourney wheel, so I can try and make sure that they're all going to be done at the same angle. So I'm pretty much going to be spraying it from there, spraying it from there. So now I've got all the Dark Reaper painted on all of those guys there. I'm going to put some Xerius Purple, I believe that's how it's pronounced. I always use a wet palette because of course I just find it easier to control my paints on a wet palette. And it kind of instantly dilutes them a little bit without doing too much work, which is always great if you're not great at thinning your paint. I've never been the greatest, why I like to airbrush. Right. I've got that pirate guy, Kaptin Badruk, that's the one. I'm going to be using Xerius Purple on his well, his coat is the best way of putting it. Just try keeping to downward strokes if you can, and just get that painted up before we come back into more of the camouflage colours. Now guys, Xeris Purple can be a little thin, so it's best to let it completely dry before putting on the second coat for your Duncan approved two thin coats. While that's happening, grab your previous models. We're going to do some patterns. So we've got some Dawnstone, we've got some Aberdeen Black. We're going to create sort of triangles or zigzags or whatever patterns you've seen. I've already got some Dawnstone loaded up in my palette. And I'm just going to do, because we're doing batch painting, I'm going to do four of them, five of them, four of them, the Commandos, and then the other set. I'm going to knock some on the floor by accident. And we're going to do that in stages, and that's simply because the variety of models will stop it from getting boring. We're going to put on Dawnstone first, we're going to put it on, like I say, in patterns, and then we're going to attach the patterns with the Aberdeen Black. Right, we've got the purple down, nice solid coat now, and we've got also, I'm going to show you on that one, we've got our Dawnstone and we've got the black. So we've got our little symbols, our little, I'll find the other one with the coat, this is to show you guys, got our blocks of colour on all of our orcs. And now we're just going to thin down a little bit of Nuln Oil. You can do it in the right palette if you want. Get your big brush. And we're going to go over all of the camouflage pattern that we've done before we move on to doing more on that purple. So, on your camouflage, your grey camouflage, I've just done a little light dry brushing of Administratum Grey. If you want to on these guys, because we didn't do enough for highlight, you can also do their boots. So we've got some form of urban camo going. To finish off the urban camouflage, I'm just going to use a bit of white. I think my white's going off a little. And what I want is a very thin point. I might use a thinner brush, maybe. And where I've got, I'll do it on the big guy here, and where we've got some patterns, I just want to put two lines. Now you can have dots if you want. I'm just going to put two lines in random sections over some of the patterns, and this will mainly towards either, you know, dark grey or black, but this will finish my camouflage colour. So might as well finish this guy off. You crack on and think of your own things. Like I say, you can have dots if you want. I might do dots on, or a different pattern on some of the other guys. It hasn't all got to be the same. Try if you can to put them everywhere. Now, we're going to be going on to Kaptin Badruk. And as you can see, I've kind of covered his chest up with the tack of blue. And this is because we're going to be highlighting his cape using an airbrush. We're going to go quite bright purple, and then we're going to use the shade purple to bring it down. So, the first colour we're going to be using is Jean Stealer Purple, and we're going to be putting that, of course, straight in, thin down, and we're going to be doing some highlights. Now we've added a bit of white It's Vallejo Game Air White to VG and Steeler Purple, and we're going to do a little bit more extreme highlighting. Now that we've got our transitional purple, we're going to coat it with a mixture of Drinky Violet with some Larmium Medium. Now we're back to some tedious bits. This is where you kind of stick your headphones on and just crack on. We're going to get some Abaddon Black and we're going to paint up all of the shoulder plates and all of the back plates. So all of these shoulder pieces, see them there, and all of these back banners that will be metal, we're going to paint them black because we're going to be doing something special for the flash kits. Now flash kits need to be flashy, but the commission requires for me to match them up with the rest of the army, hence why they're wearing combat fatigues, and now we're going to be making them black. If you want to at the same time, which is what I'm going to do, I'm going to be painting the boots black. I'm also going to be painting his boots black and any metallic, again, the shoulder pads and these metallic banners at the back of Badruk are also going to be painted up black as well. And I'm also going to be painting up his sword black. Right, you need to get your head down, you need to get cracking. Let's go. Right, so next up, we're going to be using some Mystic White from Green Stuff World. This is a white metallic colour. And the reason I'm doing this is because, of course, if you start putting it on, if you use this Mystic White with some of the contrast paints that we're going to be using later, we're going to get some really cracking effects. So, effectively, on here we've got, can't really see it, apologies. Down we go, and up we go, and hey, here we are. So, we've got the guns from the flash kits. They're going to be, we're going to kind of do a zenithal highlight. We're also going to be doing a zenithal highlight on back banners, on shoulder pads, and that's the wrong model. These guys, when they've got a helmet, we're going to be doing it down there as well. So kind of just aiming straight down with the airbrush and getting a nice zenithal highlight effect with the helmet. And then we'll be going over all this lot with some contrast paint. We're doing it on the guns because we're wanting to make the guns look flashy, effectively make it look like they've got some really cool looking armor, and the same for basically these lads here. Right, let's crack on. Now we've got the metal white on, pretty good. We're now going to start putting on some contrast paint, and I'll be honest with you, I've already done some blue because I like the idea of these guys having blue helmets, so that's all nice and drying. We're now going to basically do a mixture, a variety of colours on all of these guys. Now I have got an Ork flesh contrast out, which you know you normally wouldn't do, but I think some of the faces, if they're done in an Ork flesh, might look all right. The rest of it, like the bone bits, I might do sort of a Nazrag yellow. I've got the Blood Angels red, we've got the Telesar blue, I've even got the Vulpas pink, and we're going to be doing that on everything, including various different panels on here. We're going to be painting them with different colors to give it the garish sort of feel that you're going to get from the flash kits, because I like to show off. So that's going to be the idea. These guys are going to be really, really ostentatious, and the blue helmets mainly are because they're, you know, the looters. They're kind of, in my old school days, they used to be old death schools. There we go. Now they're not, and now you can have them in whatever. So these are now going to be blood axes with blue helmets. Yeah, just copying the Blood Angel Devastator team. Right, randomise all this slot, paint it on as best you possibly can. Try not to get onto any of the cloaks and everything else that you're doing. And once it's dry, we'll come back in. So, what you're going to have to do next is a bit of dry brushing. So get your meter on a medium dry brush here. And we're going to lead belcher, and we're going to dry brush the lead belcher on the large looter weapons. And what we're trying to do, crap, that's come off, never mind, I'll sort that in a second. Just trying to put a bit more silvering in, but try if you can, with it being a dry brush, not to catch a lot of the, because on these particular weapons, you've more than likely got some form of white highlight going on with the white metallic. So just basically just try and hit areas that don't really have the white metallic. And it'll keep it quite dull, but it'll be a nice dulled metal. And then we'll be making that sparkle later on. But do that to these weapons. Don't do it to anything else. Now, we've got that kind of dry brushed from underneath. We're still keeping a nice shine from the metallic white. And we're going to get some orc skin started. So, you can either use, at the moment I've got, I managed to get some old paint pots, so I've actually got an abundance of Dark Angel Green that I need to use. I've also got some Caliban Green as well, because that's effectively supposed to be the same colour. It's slightly darker, but you get the same results after we've done everything else, because we're going to be using some more modern paints. So basically, grab your standard brush, let's get your wet palette out, and let's give these guys a couple of layers of green on the skin. Next, once all that is dry, which should be, apologies if I've got a bit of an injury which I need to let the air get to, so apologies if you see this, and I might have to put a warning on. basically get some Mook Green, we're going to dry brush it off, and then we're going to heavily dry brush, so yeah, that's fine, you can't see me injury, it's alright, we're going to heavily dry brush the orc face, making sure not to catch anything else. You can help it. I mean, don't get me wrong, you'll probably catch the bits that's on the orc skin. But don't worry about that, we'll be coming back to that. And once you've dry brushed all that, you're then going to go over the whole thing with contrast orc flesh, which should give it a bit of a colour, and it'll dull down these this heavy dry brush. And then you do a light dry brush of Mook Green again, mainly getting an orc flesh that kind of looks a bit like that. It's quick and easy, so let's crack on. A bit of a trick with the typhus corrosion on the I would call them death skulls, but we're not, they're looters I believe. We're going to paint this into a lot of the actual weapon. This is going to save us from having to paint a lot of the weapon again. We're trying to get through this quickly, so basically I've got an old brush and we're just going to, I mean that looks like an energy power pack, so that could be saved, but there's some coils there. But basically we're just going to be painting this on. Make sure you don't get it onto anything else. This is going to give us a nice rough texture to try and create some very rusted looking weapons. They are orcs after all, we don't really look after a lot of their equipment. Apart from maybe the blood axes. Now that has dried and created the texture that we require for later, we are now going with that brush to use some Rhinox hide, and we're going to paint all of the brown, well, areas that we want to be leather. We're also going to paint up all of the areas we want to be burgundy red. So I'm using a wet palette just to thin it down a little bit, but also to keep the consistency of the paint going. It's good that's a thick print. Now it's a nice dark brown, a Rhinox hide, but what I'm going to be doing to show you on this model here is these are going to be burgundy red, so we're going to be base coating them in the brown, and then any leather straps, this is an old brush so I can get it done quickly, any leather straps we're just going to be then making that, and any pouches we're going to make that also brown, but how we highlight it will make them different colours. So get on with it, come back to me when you've done. Alright, now we've got our base, we're going to be painting up the brown. We're going to be using Mournfang and Scrag. As you can see, wet palette there. We're going to be basically just blending these up per figure. And we're going to be doing it while the actual thing is wet. So we're not going to be... Get a bit more water into that. So for example, these, they're going to be painted up. Just put a properly wet palette here, and we're going to be doing this while we are, while everything is still very wet. Get right to the point of highlight. It should blend it nicely. If you do it like this, you should be able to get a really, really good consistency all the way around, and it makes it very quick so we're not messing around later if we're keeping it wet on the model. So don't know what you sat here for, crack on. Now we're going to do exactly the same thing, as you can see there, with the red. So basically, let me find somebody decent, there we are, we're going to start, make sure it's nice and thinned down. We're going to start with some corn red, and then we're going to blend it up to Evil Sun Scarlet. Might be a little loaded. Just trying to leave a lot of, apologies, mark my thumb. Just trying to leave that bottom bit, I'll paint in the majority of this. I'm just trying to leave it like a recessed shade of the brown. Now with the red, you're best off waiting for one layer to dry. So if you want to do a couple of figures at a time and then come back and then do the next layer, and then you just keep doing that with like a couple of figures, that's probably going to be your best bet, just to try and make it and build it up. Right, as usual, kiddie winks, crack on. Next step, let's get on with some lead belcher. Traditional silver coming up. Yes, I do thin it a little, not too much, because it has a habit of separating. Now I'm going to be painting areas that I want, any sort of metalwork areas and any handles on weapons, and possibly especially on this guy here, forgotten his name, but all of the weapon I'm painting silver apart from the one I've already done, and of course the handle, because we're going to come back over with some contrast paint again, similar to what we've done before, to try and give it a different effect. So, crack on. Bit of a gear change, we've got all that silver painted, we're going to be coming to highlighting that later. We're now going to get some sponges. Now if you haven't got a sponge, just basically packing foam that you can get for your miniatures, just tear that off, or even normal sponge. And what we're going to do, some of these particular models that I've got here, I've got what I call a plasma end, and I'm effectively going to paint that in my traditional yellow plasma colour. If you are following at home, but I'm going to get, because of course it's supposed to be rusted and done away with, wobbly, and I'm going to get my sponge, I'm going to dip it, I'm just going to knock it against the lid, and I'm actually just going to paint it haphazardly with the sponge, trying not to get onto anything else that's around it. That way it'll make it look like it's worn and dirty. We will be doing some other stuff with that later, but any of those that you've got, just grab hold of them. I think there's another one in there. Paint that up and then kind of give it a bit of a highlight with the other yellow. So next upon the figures, we're going to be using Carrick Stone. Now, what this is going to actually go on to is anything like, if, for example, on Kaptin Badruk, we're going to be putting Carrick Stone onto here. We're going to be doing something special with Kaptin Badruk later, but at the moment, we're going to be putting the Carrick Stone on there. And any other orc that's got a bit of a loincloth going on, there's some somewhere. And then any twine or string, so like at the back here, we've got some string holding on bullets, we've got some string holding on the wrists. Make sure you're swapping between a thicker and a thinner brush. Same for these guys, if you've got any string or anything like that, or any dangly piece, do this in the Carrick Stone. And then of course, that's gonna be all uniform across the board. And the idea is once I've highlighted, I'm gonna try and make it look like maps, because these are blood axes, so we're gonna use tactics. Spelt the Ork way. So put little bits of that on. Like I say, make sure that that's on. You might need two thin coats of Carrick Stone, so just go through the set and go through the set again. So we've got the cloth on. Next step, we're going to be painting everything, every sort of like bony area or skull or anything of that nature, with a mixture of your Shepherd Bone and White Scar. Now, the reason I'm doing that is because I'm basically just going to use a wash to try and get everything shaded. So if we're automatically kind of putting the lighter shades on there, just making it a little bit brighter. So yeah, so things like this guy's skull cap, we're going to be painting that. Make sure to get all the areas. Just being very careful not to get on anything else. And we're also going to be painting like the skull one is, because he's actually got a skull here as well. So if we paint that up, and then when we come to the wash, that'll actually thin it down. And make this paint a little thinner. My white for some reason is incredibly thick. Probably need sorting or replacing, but there we go. It's still usable at this moment in time. And again, just try and avoid, if you can, any of the other areas that you've already done. Also with this mixture, I want you to do the teeth. So any areas that's got teeth, paint them up with this mix. Careful not to get it on the jaw. And again, we're going to be shading that off. Okay, it's now shade time. And I'm being serious when I say shade time. We are getting out the Nuln Oil. We are going to be painting the Nuln Oil onto every bit of silver that we have done here. And even if you've got the cigars on there, because I've got a couple of cigars, painted the tips of the cigars with the bone, and we're going to go over it with Nuln Oil to make it look like a very odd looking sort of tobacco. So yeah, everything that's silver, crack on. Woo-hoo. Following up from that, Abrac Surf Shade. So paint all of the leather, red, bone, and the pale sort of colours that you've done. So pretty much you're giving the whole model a real good coat of this. Make sure it's not too thick, of course. You don't want to obscure all the detail. Just give it a good, if you need to thin it down as well, use some medium. Lamium medium. rather than water, because of course sometimes water can make it look coffee stained. Right, I'm going to crack on with this. Like I say, any red area, any brown sort of leather, that needs doing as well, and any creamy colour, cream slash brown colour, that will all need a grab sort of shade in. And it will all start to make sense. Now, I've skipped ahead a little bit. We've got a dry brush of Tyrant Skull, a dry brush of Necron Compound on all the metal and bone pieces. And on some of the metal areas, I have put this. This is old school flesh wash. Now, if you don't have it, you don't have to do that bit. This is just so I can get some form of like old, weird brassy looking look on the bullets. It's a bit more old school. You don't have to do that if you haven't got the flesh wash. If you want to try and do something similar, try and get wildwood, yeah, the contrast paint wildwood, and then thin it down with a bit of medium. That'll probably give you the similar effect, maybe not as glossy because the old school inks were glossy. I am slowly but surely running out of that, but I do think I've got another pot, thankfully. But it is old and it does create quite a nice looking contrast when you've got it. It's not actually on that figure at all, but when you've got it on the actual bullets that you can just paint silver over, something that I like to do. Now, next up, we're going to be getting some contrast paints, and the contrast paint we're getting out first is Black Templar. Say how much I complain about this, I do use it quite a lot. So Black Templar, we're going to be putting it on the weapons and also the tricorn hats on those particular guys. So those guys are going to have black on, and basically I'm going to be doing it on all of the basic looking weapons. So it's normally on Badruk. Here, parts of the Chesticatian will have this, and then of course on the Commandos I'm going to be doing that, parts of the Chesticatian on the pistols as well, that's going to be blacked up. So basically all you need to do is just follow the instructions that Games Workshop gives you. Just get it loaded on your brush and paint it on. I did also forget to mention I painted grey sear into certain areas, so the feather on Badruk, the eyes on the Noblike characters, and of course some of the other bits like the lights on there I've actually painted up with that colour. So apologies if I didn't tell you, but carry on with your black and I'll tell you what to do with them next. So you should now have your grey sear on. And then all of the black has been done, and I've also done the cables with the black as well. So if you've got any dangling cables, mainly on the weapons, I've done those in black. We've got some rioter colour going on with these flash gates mixed in with the dull colours of the commandos. With bits of red, just so we can make them stand out a little. Right, I've already put apothecary white into the feather. I think a bit of my dirt water went in there, but that'll add to the effect. And then we've got Telesar Blue, and all this Telesar Blue is going to go. That is a brand new pot, and I shouldn't have opened that. Never mind. The Telesar Blue is going to go into the lights that we've done. So all of these little points. Don't do it on the eye, because we're going to do something different with that. But yeah, just basically get a blob. Just a nice blob of Telesar Blue on those lenses. So next up we've got some contrast medium with some Nasdreg yellow, so I'm wanting just to thin down the Nasdreg a little, and then we're going to put it across the eye. Now the eye, we're going to put it into the eye. Do the same on the other one. There's two. And then dry off your brush. Do the first one. And rub it off the centre. So you've nearly got. Just look at that. That is what you are after. That's working nicely. So there you go, if you can just see that there. Apologies if it's not saturating right, but it's, I'll see if I can get a better picture, but it's very, very, yeah, hang on. So hopefully you can see that on the image there, is that it's very, it was a very yellow, and I've kind of rubbed it away to a, like a yellowy stained whitish in the center, because that's what I'm after. I'm not after a glorified section, I'm just after something where it's just going to be quite like a yellowy outer rim, and then we're going to be painting like targeters in the middle of that, as well as painting some maps maybe on some loincloths. Right, here we go, this is where we now get into some nitty-gritty crunch time, and it's mainly going to be airbrushing. Okay, so before we proceed, I'm wanting to do a crosshair on here. So I'm going to be using some Evil Sun Scarlet, which I'm going to thin right down in my wet palette. Now, I'm trying to get it to the point where it's usable to the point where I can just get it off, but let's see if I can. What's going on? Yeah, right now. You're going to have to try and change your brush. One of the things a lot of people sometimes forget when they're using small amounts of paint is that it dries quick. So I know I've got the paint here and it's nice and wet, but once it's on the brush, it's drying. So it can dry quickly. You want to not move quick, but kind of do it as you can. And then clean your brush off, make sure the brush is dry, and then get a bit more. And that way you're not gonna have a point where you're like, it's not coming off the brush, and then you try a bit harder, and then you mess it up. That's sometimes what certain people can do with freehand. Now, I'm gonna try and make a circle here. I don't like circles. Brushes are not designed for circles. And once you've got your basic down, just kind of reinforce it and just go over it again. Get a nice little targeting eye, which I'm going to do on both of them. So, airbrush time. To start off with, I'm going to be looking at doing vast majority, which is basing. So, I'm going to be doing these two colours. Now, I'm going to be doing steelage and drab to begin with. That's going to go as like a dusting on the boot. So, I'm going to put that on first. That's kind of going to go up like any bottom running cloaks, just a little bit. Quite like the colour of that, so I might avoid that if I kind of just put it on the boots. But any sort of like legs or trims, put that on there, just a little dusting of it. And then when we put that on, if we catch any of the legs, it'll make it look like it's dirt. So this is a really good way of making sure that you can paint a lot of bases quite quick. Once them two have dried, we're going to go for a dry brush, heavy dry brush of on overbrush of scrag brown, just to catch all the raised areas. And then finish it off with some Tyrant Skull dry brush. And then of course you can put your little bits of grass and things of that nature on there. This is just a basic base. Once we've done that, we're going to come back and do the other thing. Next up, I've got some Lothian Blue, and I'm going to be putting some Game Air White, Glazio Game Air White, into it as well to lighten it up in a moment. But we are just going to effectively do a lot of the vents and things. So a lot of what looks like plasma venting or maybe some plasma ends. We're just going to kind of spruce them up. So on here, just going to give that a And we're just going to do that on majority of the plasma weapons. I might even do it on some of these plasma bullets. And the same if you're doing the same, if you're doing the same models as me, I'm also doing that on these guys as well. So bits like the end of the section of the plasma, you know, effectively because that's a plasma end anyway, I'm just going to paint it up. Just try and avoid getting, if you're doing it here, try and avoid getting it onto the faces. Try and cover it up as best as you possibly can. Little things like maybe one of the backpacks, like this backpack here with the coils, put some blue on that, and that'll just quickly give a slight variation, a bit of definition or change to the models that you're already painting.
There we go, a bunch of orcs painted up quickly and looking all right. A bit of a shine because of the varnish that I've used, but that'll die down soon. Just little touches and little flares like the map on Badruk's loincloth, the little target which is emulating the one from the box, and of course we've got some Blood X Commandos in there, and we've got some shooters or looters, that's the one, some looters as well. But thank you very much for watching, guys. Please like, share, subscribe, hit the notification button if you do want to see more. Hopefully going to have like maybe a Necromunda painting one coming soon, another version of Enforcers, that's the one, and maybe even a couple more Ork videos coming. Well, thank you very much, guys. We will see you next time.